with the goal of by the year 2050, we want to have full-size humanoid robots like Charlie play against the human World Cup champions in a real game of soccer and win. So towards that goal, we're pushing the technology. This year, we're glad to, happy to let you know that we won first place in the adult size and also won first place with this small guy called Darren Opie, which I'm going to talk about in a minute. And we won the most prestigious Best Humanoid Robot Louis Vuitton Club beautiful Baccarat Crystal Trophy that we probably couldn't bring it here today. But JK is our PhD student who's the main architect for Charlie. And we're going to show you a very small, short demonstration. Well, first of all, we're going to make it walk. Yep, want to do that? So that we take it for granted walking with 2 feet because you walk with 2 feet. However, there's only a handful of groups in the world that actually implement full-size bipedal walking like Charlie. This is a very difficult thing to achieve for many, many reasons. Mechanical design, dynamics, controls, power, actuation. So Charlie has a camera in its head. It uses vision processing for localization and object recognition. So it looks around and tries to build a model of the world to understand what it is. Also, localization is, it tries to figure out where he is in this world using cameras. In its pelvis, we have an IMU, initial measurement unit. It's basically three-axis rate gyro, three-axis accelerometer to figure out the balance. And we use that for the feedback to balance itself. Pardon? Yes, we are using ZMP control as it is. So if we actually push it, we don't want to do it, but if we push it, it knows how to rebalance itself. Slightly, yeah. We don't want to push it too hard, but yeah. So the processor it's using, of course, each of the joints are distributed control, uses PID control, position control, but the main brain is a generic single board computer with a Intel Atom processor, 1.8 gigahertz, I think, and it runs LabVIEW right now. Another quote-unquote secret project for the Navy that we're having is called Sapphire. It's a shipboard autonomous firefighting robot. That is another humanoid robot that we're developing. That one will be using the single board Rio using NI technology. We hopefully will be able to introduce that to the world next year at NI Week. All right, so now I want to demonstrate the smaller brother of Charlie. This guy is called Darwin. By the way, Charlie stands for Cognitive Humanoid Autonomous Robot with Learning Intelligence. Darwin stands for Dynamic Anthropomorphic Robot with Intelligence. It's called Darwin OP. OP stands for Open Platform. We've been working on the Darwin series since 2004. You've probably seen Darwin on the keynote stage, what that was, 4 years ago. So we've been working on Darwin. It's been evolving, evolving, evolving. Now it's mature enough to actually introduce to the world. This is a fully open source software and open source hardware platform, which means that all the mechanical design, CAD files, how to build it, fabricate the parts, assemble it, all the components are listed, are all open source. You can download it for free. You can make one for yourself. Other universities are actually making Darwin OPs right now. And also people are hacking it. They put Hokuyo laser rangefinders on the head, different type of grippers on the hand. Software is also open source, C++, Java, of course, LabVIEW, anything goes. People use Ubuntu, Linux, Windows, anything goes. You can't program it as it is. Everything is open source. So we're going to show some Darwin OP soccer playing capabilities. You want to put the button for me? So Darwin OP also shares almost the identical software structure with Charlie. It's just a little bit smaller and cuter. There you go. So nobody's remote controlling it. It's just using its camera to follow this ball. Just to make it simpler, we just make it follow red color stuff, right? Kick the ball towards Darwin OP if you could. So everything is done real time, obviously, onboard processing. Yeah. He likes the color red. Anybody with a red shirt or a red skirt, if you're here, he's gonna follow you. There you go. Yeah. See, he likes easier. Over there, over there. Wow. So Darwin OP, of course, we're using it for robot soccer as a demonstration, but it's a really general research robot. Other universities are using it for multi-robot coordination, vision processing, networking, dynamics and control, walking gait. So it's a really nice platform. So for this robot, I mentioned that we've been working on the Darwin series for a long time. We've been getting so many emails and phone calls from other research labs and universities that they want to have Darwin. So this is our contribution to the society. It's a fully free open source robot. It's sponsored by the National Science Foundation. We developed it together with Purdue University, University of Pennsylvania, and a company called Robotis. So the company Robotis actually is selling this robot. So if you want to buy it, you can buy it as a product. You can build your own. Build just the parts that's easy to make and purchase the difficult to make the parts. So it's all up to you. We're forming an online user community. So people are already modding the codes, uploading new improved software. So it's a true open source development. Yeah. Thank you. So again, Darwin won first place in RoboCup in the kid size. Charli won first place in the adult size. So now we're the world champions. I'm very proud of our robots and very proud of all of our students. We've been working really hard on these projects. So there you go. Thank you very much.